What's up, peers, and welcome to Bitcoin to the Max here on the World Crypto Network. And of course, we continue today the reading of the phenomenal book, What Has Government Done to Our Money, Applying It to Bitcoin. Both ebook and audiobook available for free, as information should be, thanks to the amazing Mises Institute, a fountain of knowledge, the amazing website. Talking about stabilizing the price level. Pierce, how often have FUDsters said that the Bitcoin price is too volatile, that we need to have a stable purchasing power like the very stable US dollar fiat shitcoin has? Clearly, let's dissect this. Some theorists charge that the free monetary system would be unwise because it would not stabilize the price level. For example, the price of the money unit. Well, Bitcoin, they say, is supposed to be a fixed yardstick that never changes. Therefore, its value or purchasing power should be stabilized. Since the price of Bitcoin would admittedly fluctuate on the free market, a freedom must be overruled by government management to ensure stability. How the government would go about this is unimportant at this point. Well, but basically, it would involve governmentality managed changes in the money supply. Stability would provide justice, for example, to debtors and creditors who will be sure of paying back shitcoins or Bitcoin for the same purchasing power as they are lent out. Yet, if creditors and debtors want to hedge against future changes in purchasing power, well, they can do so easily on the free market. When they make their contracts, they can agree their repayment will be made in the sum of money adjusted by some agreed upon index number of changes in the value of Bitcoin. The stabilizers have long advocated such measures, but strangely enough, the very lenders and borrowers who are supposed to benefit from such stability have rarely availed themselves of the opportunity. Must the government force on certain benefits on people who have already freely rejected them? Apparently, entrepreneurs would rather take their chances in this world of irremediable uncertainty on their ability to anticipate the conditions of the market. After all, the price of Bitcoin is no different from any other free market price on the market. They can change in response to change in demand of individuals. Well, why not the monetary price? Artificially stabilization would in fact seriously distort and hamper the workings of the market. And we have indicated people would be unavoidably frustrated in their desire to alter their real proportion of cold storage. There would be no opportunity to change cold storage in proportion to price. Furthermore, improved standards of living come to the public from the fruits of capital investment. Increased productivity tends to lower prices and costs, and thereby distribute the fruits of free enterprise to all the public, raising the standards of living of all peers. Forcibly propping up of the price level prevents the spread of higher living standards. Money, in short, is not a fixed yardstick. It is a commodity serving as a medium of exchange. Flexibility in its value in response to consumer demands is just as important and just as beneficial as any other free pricing of the market. Again, Rothbard provides here in this phenomenal book all the knowledge that you need in order to defeat all the nonsensical arguments of FUDsters and no-coiners and multi-shit-coinerers. The price of Bitcoin truly doesn't matter. It's a medium of exchange. And this, of course, prerequisites a store of value. But ultimately, a stable purchasing price would mean that we cannot achieve prosperity. Because look at this. A computer back in the 1980s filled up a huge room and costs thousands of shitcoin dollars and had almost no computational power. Well, now we have our phones, which cost, what, another thousand of these shitcoin dollars? But, well, they can do much, much, much more. And if you would want, for example, a 1 megabyte hard drive, which cost back in the days a fortune, well, now you can get a terabyte hard drive for pretty much nothing. So if we have a stable price level, this means that even today, you could get this phone, which has a lot of the computational power, and you would have to pay a fortune for it. Well, because the price has to be stable. Well, no. We humans advanced. We increase our productivity. We increase the prosperity. And this leads to lower prices or an increase in the price of Bitcoin. So no, Bitcoin will not and will never have a stable purchasing power, because that would mean that we would retract, that we would shrink, and that we would not grow and expand and venture to new lands. No, the unstable purchasing power, the price volatility of Bitcoin, it's not a bug, it's a feature, because that allows us to grow in our prosperity on the marketplace. Pierce, thank you again for sticking here through on this phenomenal read. I hope you enjoyed of this beautiful book, What Has Government Done to Our Money? And again, I hope you by now realize it truly is a must read for every Bitcoin. Pierce, thank you for supporting the show on teleco.in/HillebrandMax and for getting all the early releases of this show as soon as I produce them. Pierce, thank you very much and see you on the next show. Bye-bye.